Hello students, today we are going to start chapter 4. That is, the name of the chapter is decimal. This chapter is going to be included in your next half yearly examination. So let us start the chapter. Before proceeding towards the any question, we have to understand what is decimal. Now, earlier you have learned about the number system. You have learned in this way. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, in this way and so on. Now, after ones, here it is decimal. After ones, here the decimal is. Now, what will be the place after the decimal? So, first place after decimal is called 10. T-E-N-T-H, 10. And its value is represented as 1 by 10. Next, after 10, it is written as 100. The value is written as 1 by 100. Next, same 1000. And it is represented as 1 by 1000. So here you can see, before decimal, 1 stands 100, 1000, 10,000. And after decimal, 10, that is 1 by 10, 100, 1 by 100, 1000, 1 by 1000. So here, in the recap exercise, we have our first question. Write the decimal values of the given digits. You have to write the decimal values of the given digits. In your question, 7 is written in bold. So here I have underlined it. That means you have to find the decimal place of 7. Now, how to do it? Let us write the question once again. Now, you have to find the decimal place of this one, 7. You have to write it, the decimal value of 7 in 0.437 is, what it will be? After decimal, it is the first place. 4 is in the first place. That means, the place value of 4 is 10. Place value of 3 is 100. And the place value of 7 will be 1000. So, 1000 is written as 1 by 1000, as I have showed you earlier. So, how can you write it? This 7 you will write here and its place is 10, 100, 1000. So this 1000 will be written here. So answer will be 7 by 1000. Hope so you have understood this and the remaining rest, number B, C and D, I think you can do it by yourself. Now let us write question number 2. Okay, so in our question number 2, we have to convert this into decimal number. Now, how to convert this into decimal number? First of all, we should always rewrite the question. After writing it, this, whatever number we have in the numerator, this numerator you should write here. You have written the numerator. Now, you have to see how many zeros are there in the denominator. In our denominator, we have 2 zeros. That means, you have to place the decimal before 2 digits. Denominator 2 zero, that means you have to place the decimal before 2 digits. So how will you count? You will count it from this side, not from this side, from right to left, 1, 2. So here before 2 digits you have to place your decimal. Now before decimal, if there is not any digit, then you have to write a 0 here. So this is your answer, 0.39 is your answer. So here now in our question number 3, state the number of decimal places. This is your question, 0.7523. I'll rewrite the question once again. Now, according to the question, you have to write only the number of decimal places. That means you have to see how many digits are there after decimal. After decimal, this is our decimal point. After decimal, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. After decimal, here we have 4 digits. So, in the answer, you are going to write the number of decimal places is 4. If there are two digits after decimal, then you have to write the number of decimal places is 2. If there is 3 digits, then you are going to write 3. Now, here in this question, we have 4 digits after decimal. So that's why we have written the number of decimal places is 4. So here in our question number 4, the question is write the following as decimals. You have to write this in decimal form. Now I have written the question once again. Now here in your question you can see 4 by 10 plus 3 by 100 plus 1 by 1000. Now this 4 by 10, forget about these two. Think about this only, 4 by 10. Now this 4 by 10 can be written as I said you earlier, numerator number you will write here. Sorry. Then you have to see the denominator, how many zeros are there. Here in this denominator you have only 1 zero. Now that means you have to put the decimal before 1 digit. Counting from this side, before 1 digit you have to place the decimal. If there is no any number, then you are going to write a 0. Now here it is over. Now this plus sign you are going to put here. Again same you will repeat here. This numerator you are going to write here. Denominator you have 2 zeros. That means you are going to place decimal before 2 digit. But here you have only 1 digit. So what you have to do? You have to add 1 zero more here. Now counting from left, sorry, counting from right, 1, 2. Before 2 digit you have to place the decimal. Again 1 zero here. Same thing again, this plus sign you will write here. Numerator you have 1. Now in the denominator you have 3 digits. Sorry, 3 zeros. Now that means you have to place the decimal before 3 digit. Now since we have only 1 digit here, we require 2 more digit. So that means we have to add 2 zeros more. Now here total we have 3 digit. We can place the decimal now. 1, 2, 3. Now this 3 you have to add it. How can you add? You can do at your rough work 0.4, then 0.03, then 0.001. While writing in this way, you have to keep in mind that all the decimals should be in serially. It should be arranged serially in a proper order. Now 1, 3, 4, 0. So your answer is 0.431. Hope so you have understood it, and the rest remaining number B, C, D, you try it by yourself. So here students, in your question number 5, write each of the following as decimal number. Here the question is 9 tenth. It means what? You have to write 9 tenth in decimal form. So this 9 you are going to write here and 10. 10th means you will write it as 1 by 10. 1 by 10 means your denominator should be 10. Here numerator is 9 and denominator will be 10. Now 9 by 10, how can you write in decimal form? The numerator you write here. Now look at the denominator. You have 1 digit. Sorry, 1 0. That means you have to place the decimal before 1 digit. Before decimal, if you don't have any digit, then simply add a 0 here. So your answer is 0.9. It is very easy. So remaining, you try by yourself. So dear students, instead of showing question number 3, I have written directly question number, sorry, question numbers. Instead of showing you question number 6, I have written question number 7 directly. Why? Because question number 6 is similar to as earlier sum, which we did. In your question number 6, simply you have to arrange the numbers in decimal way and add it. Now, question number 7. In your question number 7, you are directed to subtract it. You have to subtract 5.65 from 7.88. Whenever you have from, whenever you see from in the question, from 7.88, it means what? This 7.88 you have to write first. Because it is your greater number. Out of these two, which one is greater? 7.88 is greater. So from greater number, we should subtract the smaller one. 5.65. So arrange it in this way. Now 8 minus 5, 3. 8 minus 6, 2. This decimal you will write here. 7 minus 5, 2. So here your answer is 2.23. Isn't it easy? So remaining, you do it by yourself. And remember one more thing. It is not that simply I am giving the lecture and you will just simply see or watch it. You have to note it down at your maths copy. And as soon as the school reopens, I will surely check it. Okay. So dear students, here you can see in your question number 8, you have to convert it into like decimal. Like decimal means what? Like decimal means the same number of digit after decimal. Here you can see after decimal you have 1 digit. Here you can see after decimal you have 2 digit. And here it is 3 digit. That means what? Here 1, here 2 and here 3 digit. So you have to do what? You have to take the highest number of digits. So highest number of digit is 3. That means it has 3 places after decimal. That means the other remaining 2 also you have to change it into 3 decimal places. Now how will you change it? 7.5. After decimal you have only 1 digit. To make it 3 digit you require 2 more digit. So what you have to do? You have to add 2 more zeros here. Now 6.25. Here you have after decimal 2 digit. To make it a 3 digit number, you have to add 1 zero here. Now it has become 3 digit. Here it will remain same as it is. Now you can see 7.500. After decimal, you have 3 digit. After decimal, 3 digit. After decimal, 3 digit. That means what? You have to keep in your mind that whenever you change your question into like decimal. Like decimal means same number of decimal places. Okay, you have to make all the numbers, decimal places equal. Earlier in the question, here it is 1 digit. Here it is 2 digit. Here it is 3 digit. That means after decimal 1 place, after decimal 2 place, after decimal 3 places. So here in your answer, it has become after decimal 3 places, here also 3 places, here also 3 places. That means all are equal. Now it has been changed into like decimal.